lie there? Do you have the feeling that your bow grip and your struggles with it is really holding you back from your progress on the violin, and your lessons and your practice are all the time about that bow grip? Why can't you just get it right and move on? Well, these 5 learning aids for bow holds can maybe be helpful. I'm quite a conservative teacher in some areas, and I was against them for years, but I changed my mind. In this video, I'm going to test all 5 of them and let you know my thoughts and how helpful they could be for you. If you are completely new to my channel, my name is Latta. I'm a violinist living in Holland, and I help violin players worldwide overcome their technical struggles and express their feelings in music by teaching them all about bow technique. If you're interested in that, then subscribe to my channel for free weekly violin lessons. Now, let me tell you, I was extremely skeptical about these things, and what I was taught at a conservatory is that a student must develop his own bow hold and to let it be flexible and relaxed and in a good balance, and with every finger performing their own function. However, I got these bow hold buddies to test, and I just went to search for more information. And I actually find the research behind it, the experiences from teachers, quite convincing. They are actually right, so I was a little bit too conservative, perhaps. If you are a self-learner watching these videos on YouTube, then this is great to prevent bad habits. And almost everyone, and certainly self-learners, develop bad habits on the violin because the basic technique is just very difficult and it needs to be right to be able to progress. So it's awesome if you can have this right bow hold right out of the box, so to say, and then you can focus on other things. And the problem I see with a lot of adult learners, and I know that in my audience there are a lot of adult learners, is that you don't tense up, because adults just tense up so much and then they can't get their bow hold right. Well, if you use the bow hold buddies, you can relax, and not only your hand can relax, but also your whole bow arm. And then it's so much easier to bow straight, to get a good tone, all these things. So I think that it just is useful. Just don't use it for many, many years, because then you become, and that was my fear for these learning aids, you become dependent on them and you don't really learn the balance. But what I was wrong about as a teacher, and of course I'm constantly developing as well and learning too here, is that I thought that, you know, you don't learn the motor skills of a good bow hand because your bow hand has to move all the time. But what I now discovered is that actually, when you have this good bow hold right out of the box, then you can first of all focus on other areas of your playing and develop those and get progress right there. And in the beginning, you just don't have the strength and the flexibility to keep everything in place. And what's great about the bow hold buddies, and I'll show you the other options in a sec, is that you do have the good contact points, and the contact points of, you know, your fingers on the bow, they're very important in developing a good bow technique in general, and a good tone production in general. So they are there. Even the pinky nest, you see, you can touch the bow. So you have the bow hold as it should be, you just have a little bit more support, and when you don't have this balance of flexibility and strength yet, you can still bow in a correct manner. And what I read is that your motor skills have developed in a couple of months, so you get a result quite fast. And what I love about the bow hold buddies is that you can remove this one if you don't need it, and if you still have that slipping pinky that a lot of people struggle with, you just use this one. You just use the fish, and that can be useful for quite a while. So you can actually gradually move to a good bow hold, which I think is awesome, and this is something that other learning aids for bow grip don't have. So here's what it looks like without a frog and just a little fish. And you just have this little support to keep your pinky in the right spot. And for a lot of people, that's all they need. And maybe you can remove that frog quite quickly. What's also very smart about it, so, you know, the design of this is really thought out. It looks very simple, but when I was trying it out and thinking about my students, then I discovered so many good things about it. And I'll show you without it. The reason why people's pinky slip off the bow often is because they place it right on top of the bow. Well, the trick is to place it just on the edge right before that. Then it can't go like that very quickly, you see? And with this little fish, you can just pop it on like this. And you know, you see how easily I put it on and remove it. So if you are moving gradually to an independent bow hold, then you can just play with it for a while, then take it off for a while, and then put it on again if your pinky gets tired, or if you see that your bow hold is getting off. And in that way, you can really gradually move. But you can, you see, I can put it however I want. Smart, isn't it? And everybody holds their bow slightly different. So, you know, you can personalize this. So what I also thought, being skeptical, I thought, yeah, like it puts you in one bow hold and you can't move and you can't, you know, smoothen your bow changes and all that. But you can. You can move while playing and you can personalize it. So you're probably wondering, when should I remove these? Well, start off with the full bow hold bodies. Maybe after some months you can remove the frog. Put it back when you notice that it's going off all the time. And just see how long you need it, but don't use it for many years. Maybe the end of the first year might be good, or somewhere in the second year that you are playing. And certainly remove it before you do spaccato, because of course this all makes your bow heavier. It's not extremely heavy, but you know, a good bow is balanced in a very careful way. And you need that balance as you start with off the string bowings. Of course, preparational exercises to ricochet or spiccato you can do perfectly with the buddies, eventually you need a natural balance of the bow that you have. So that's when to remove it. So now I have to admit that I was wrong, and I now highly recommend these, and I even have a nice discount code of 15% for you. And for those in the USA, I have a nice discount code. And then you might be thinking, oh, why not in Europe? Well, because it's very expensive to get these bow hold buddies from the USA to Europe. There are local web shops in which you can get the bow hold buddies in Europe or wherever on the world, and also the website I refer to in the description, they ship everywhere. But for those in the USA, I have a 15% discount code. You need to use the link in the description and the discount code in the description, so both. So the link and the discount code. All right, so if you want to grab these, they're around $30 and $25, something like that, with the discount code. You can imagine if you need less private lessons because of this, if you just need half an hour less, then they already earned back their money. Well, so let's look at the alternatives. For 20 cents at your local drugstore. Drugstore is always a weird term if you live in the Netherlands. You can get toe spreaders. And I got them for this video because, you know, I'm an entrepreneur and a mom. I don't have time to polish my toenails. Why would I? They don't appear in the video anyway. So you put them like this and they spread your fingers a bit. That's all they do. I know a lot of teachers recommend this. You know, they just help you in one way. You can have a good bow hold with them, but they don't really support your hand on the bow because they're here. That's the only way to have them work. You know, if your difficulty in your bow hold, if you know that of yourself, that the only difficulty you have is that you put your fingers too close together, then this can be a good option. It's not expensive, so you can try it out. But I think it doesn't really offer support. So the next one's pretty ridiculous. I got it for $1 on AliExpress. Actually, you should see the pictures right here. They show a wrong bow hold. And if you're thinking, yeah, but your bow hold doesn't have to be that exact. No, of course not. Everybody has a very different bow hold. And if you compare concert violins, but there are some universal things we know that work with bow hold. And we know the function that every finger has. And you can't possibly perform those functions when you hold your bow like this, okay? So it's too far away from the frog. And you can't put it in a way because it's just stuck right here, you see? So you can't even move it. And then you have to hold your bow like this. The pictures are like the perfect example of a wrong bow hold. So definitely don't get this one. You can better use nothing instead. Then there is also the bow master, and I've seen quite a lot of students with it, and they tell me that they use it to prevent their fingers slipping. And yes, it does that, but it also makes your bow, yeah, quite chunky. It does have the good places, but still, some people want to hold their bows a little bit more there. It's not possible because, just like the other thing, you can't pull it down. You see, you also can't turn it because it's just stuck. So just like the fish, you could turn and you could personalize all these things. You can't do that. It just fits on your bow in one way. Yeah, of course you can kind of shove it up further up the bow, but that's not really helpful. You have a little pinky nest right here. That can be helpful. But what I think about this is, compared to the bow hold buddies, you can't personalize it, and you can't take it off one by one. It feels really chunky, and you don't have the contact points on the bow. So I'm just, when I'm using this in whatever way, I'm not touching the bow at all, and that's not good to develop a bow hold, because when you remove this, it will be so unnatural that it's really hard to learn. So it doesn't help you, and that was why I was so skeptical about all of this stuff, because I saw these things and I saw that it didn't help students. So if a student came in my studio and had this, I instantly told them to take it off. Now, I also got this snail from from AliExpress. It gives a lot more support. It's also good that it has this hole here, so you have your pinky on the natural place. You can have a good bow hold with this. So I think of the cheap alternatives, this is the best. But still, you know, because it's right all the way here, you don't touch the bow. Well, you touch it, yeah, like here, and you have this edge and you can't personalize it at all. The only thing you can do is to shove it a little bit there, you see, or a little bit more there. That's the only thing you can do. You can't turn it to put your pinky on the right spot, and you don't have the natural contact points because you are, yeah, mainly this edge is something I don't like. It's cheaper, it's $12. I think this doesn't really help you. So I tested all possible bow grip learning aid thingies I could find. And if you find a different one and you're wondering if it's good, then wonder those things. Like, do you have the contact points? Can you customize it, and can you remove it step by step? And it also needs to have a good material that is soft, that you really have that grip. And the fake ones are of really hard plastic, and it's not shaped in a good way, and then you don't have the advantages. So yes, I'm convinced that the bow hold buddies can really help you. I changed my mind as a violin teacher on that, but only the original bow hold buddies, because these really are the only learning aids that meet these conditions that I have. So if you don't want these, then don't get the alternative. Then just learn it from scratch, like I've learned it. But yeah, if you want the bow hold buddies, I think they can be really helpful to you if you're struggling with your bow hold and you get distracted too much by your bow hold. Use the steps that I taught you earlier in the video to take them off one by one. And yeah, I hope this is helpful. Again, if you want 15% discount and you are in the United States, then use the link below and use the discount code that I have in the description. This is my honest review. I love to hear what you think. Have you used things like this? Has it been helpful to you? Or are you completely against it, like I was before testing all these things out? Leave a comment below. And of course, if you want more reviews and, well, mainly violin lessons, that's what I weekly share on this channel, then make sure to subscribe. And I hope to see you again in one of my next videos. Bye bye! So let me show you how you install the bow hold bodies, and it's very similar for all the others I tested. So what you do is, and this might be a little bit scary for you, certainly if you do that for the first time, is that you turn the screw like you're loosening your bow, but you keep turning and turning and turning. And then, whoopsie, and your frog is loose, okay? So don't touch the hair of your bow too much. Then let's unpack the buddies. And it's a cute little frog and fish. You can also get them in the other colors, by the way, if you don't like blue for whatever reason. And then you just slide up the frog with his nose in the air. And you might feel a little bit resistant, that's okay. And then for the other bow grips, that was kind of it. The longer ones are a bit harder to install, so don't use fluids or whatever to make it slide, because yeah, that might damage your bow. Make sure your bow hair is straight, by the way, if you are turning it again. So here we have the frog on my frog. Make sure that it's in a way that, yeah, there is a position where it stays, so you'll discover that soon enough. It comes also with a manual, by the way. And then this is the little fish, the pinky nest. And you just push it on the end. And you might want to change it a little bit until you get the bow hold that you want. And then like this, you can have a great bow hold, actually. That's how they work.